I'm Valder Beebe, host of the Valder Beebe Show. I am famously known for That Celebrity Interview, interviews with today's pop icons, movie stars, and celebrities. Tune into our FM radio broadcast and our online broadcast. Visit ValderBeebeShow.com and SoundCloud.com/ValderBeebeShow. I'll see you there.
So I've got Dr. Laura Burman here. Yes. She's helped countless patients improve their sex lives and build stronger relationships. Dr. Burman, can you hear me?
I can. Sorry. I was like,
trying to hear you. Thank you so much for joining us. All right, let's talk sex. We got Valentine's Day coming up. And people, I think that we veil it under flowers and candy, but the end of the day or the end of the night, I think it's about sex.
Yeah. Well, I think it is for most people. It's a day of romance, right? And when we think romance, we think sex. And if sex is working in your relationship already, that's great, right? You're going to have a great Valentine's Day. But if it's not working, then not only may it certainly affect your Valentine's Day celebration and mood, but it affects your general relationship.
Well, don't we have the expectations, you know, we're going to, like, fix it all on these holidays and things like that?
Yeah, and a vacation or a romantic dinner, I mean, those are really important parts of maintaining a healthy relationship, but that's not necessarily all that you need, especially as we start to age, and for women especially, as we move into menopause, because there are definite sexual side effects that start to happen as those hormone levels decline. That really affect not only our desire and enjoyment, but one in three women experience pain during sex. And that, of course, will circle back to negatively affect your desire.
Okay, well, you're talking our language because my audience is made of 89.9% females, and 53% of those are baby boomers. So you're talking their language because I know many have moved into postmenopausal. So what are some of the physical cause of changes in sexual behavior when you go into menopause?
Well, you know, this is really important because historically we didn't live well past our reproductive years, you know, but thanks to modern technology, medical technology, and our healthy lifestyles, we're living a long time. We could live 30 years in postmenopause, which is great, right? We're living healthy, active lifestyles, which means that we can have sex till the very end as long as we can walk up two flights of stairs without chest pain, you know, and that is great. But the decline in our hormones as we move into menopause and especially postmenopause, especially testosterone and estrogen, which are kind of the sex hormones, create a slew of side effects. Most importantly, for your sex life, low desire and painful sex. And, you know, that obviously creates a real struggle. But it's due to hormonal changes.
Okay, so when you go into postmenopause, some women want to rest their body, but why is it important to have an active sexual life at that time?
Yeah, well, listen, sex is part of having a restful body. You know, you don't have to be swinging from the chandeliers every time, right? Like you can, it's, you know, but it's really important. It's important for your health. It's important for it helps with your immune system. It helps with cardiovascular health. If you're being intimate with a man, it helps prevent prostate cancer. It's good for your immune system. And it's obviously very important and good for your relationship. And for women especially, there have been some really fascinating studies that if she's in a good relationship, she will live significantly longer than a woman who's not in a relationship or in a bad one.
Ooh, I love that, Dr. Burman. Today, my guest is Dr. Laura Burman. She's a PhD. She's a world-renowned sex and relationship educator and therapist. Dr. Burman, if women are experiencing pain during intercourse, how do they treat these symptoms?
Well, most important, especially for postmenopausal women, is talk to your doctor. And don't necessarily expect your doctor to bring it up, because most of them won't. But you have to be your own health advocate, your best advocate in all areas of your health, but especially your sexual health. So ask your doctor about it. Tell him or her the symptoms that you're experiencing. And don't be shy, because you are so not alone. All the other women out there are going through the same thing in postmenopause. So there's nothing to be shy about, and there is help available. And I'm actually partnering with Duchenne USA, who are the makers of Asphena, which is the only FDA-approved one-time daily hormone-free oral pill out there, and it is indicated for moderate to severe painful sex. There is a possible risk, increased risk, of endometrial cancer and cardiovascular disorders, so you want to talk to your doctor about that too. But I think it's a great option for postmenopausal women.
Dr. Burman, I love a doctor who comes with details and an answer. Thank you so much. Where can we learn more online about this? Because I know there are some women who are suffering in silence, or suffering in embarrassment, as I call it.
Yeah, do your research. So if you go to asphena.com, I have some great sexpectation tips there for postmenopausal women. And I have tons of information also on my website, drlauraburman.com. But the main thing is, make sex a priority. It's good for you. It's good for your health. It's good for your relationship. And you don't have to suffer in silence.
All right, audience. Remember, call Dr. Laura Berman's name on Valentine's Day when you get what you want. Dr. Laura Burman, thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.